but they say don't say that, huh? What I'ma turn down for? I feel like Shaq and 9-4, breaking glass in that back boat. I like Kobe and Toronto, huh? Dropping 81, yo, I dropped an 88. Ricky Bobby, shake and bake, sleeping on it, should've stayed awake, huh? Everybody make mistakes like VJs, trying to say my name, it's Minio. Say it with me, Minio. Okay, great, 2 forks high, base stakes. Risk it all, I take the hate, it's the winning team, get the Gatorade. My guy good, but he's not safe, nah.
They try to shut us down and it ain't gon' slide. Only thing I fear is God and he on my side. That's the confidence I got, cause he got me. That's why I really feel like you can't stop me. That's all you got. Opponent, you know me, I know you, we know it. Whenever I fail, you always been there to simply remind me you're blown it. You don't see when I'm growing, you don't see where I'm going. You only see in the moment, you know my mistakes, you never let go. Don't cease to amaze me, and it drive me crazy. Did you catch every detail that I missed in the songs I'm making? Saying you will never write a verse like Kendrick, never be the rapper I got from Hendrix. Top 10 alive, you will never be mentioned. Why aim so high, won't survive the trenches. Plus, you a Christian, Andy. They will never listen, Andy. Plus, we a pigment, Andy. You don't got skill, you a gimmick, Andy. Well, if I listen to you and everything you put in my ear, I'll be living like woulda, shoulda, coulda. I'll be paralyzed by fear. Ain't that the truth? If I quit, the only way I lose, I got 2 choices when I do this. Make moves or make excuses, huh? If you know who I'm talking about, then you got me. My biggest enemy is me, and even I can't stop me. They try to
shut us down. Can you hear me now? All right. So I've been told if you have any music quests that you want to hear, requests that you want to hear when you come in every Wednesday, to let that guy right back there, Mr. J, in the sound booth there, let him know, and he'll put it in the lineup, okay? So let me hear it again. How's everybody doing tonight? Ah, that's a little bit better. All right.
Hello. Amaya.
Hi, Amaya. How you doing? So glad you're here today.
Going through my fifth puberty, guys. Bear with me. I'm kidding. Hey, so I wanted to throw this out there now. We'll throw it out there again. I asked you last week, whoever wanted to go on a fishing trip, if you're interested in going on fishing, let me just tell you what we'd probably do. Actually, I can't tell you the date, but we're going to go on a Friday night. We'll probably fish like in the evenings, like long time. So it's probably gonna be like a 5-6 hour fishing trip. We're gonna go probably to Jekyll Island, or we'll surf fish on the beach. That's what that means, and we'll fish for shark, and then we'll use shark bait right there, Miss. Never mind, I'm not gonna say that. So, but if you want to, please come up here and let me know, because with all the social distancing and all that crazy weird fun stuff, we may have to do 2 trips. But just let us know, because we want to make sure we can take care of that. Hey, the contact number is probably your parents' number, because we want to make sure if I say, hey, Lillianne, is this Lillianne's mama? Yeah, can I take your kids fishing? I want to make sure it's okay that you guys ride with me to go fishing, because we would be probably not 6 feet apart. Okay, so anyways, if you're interested, right up here, actually I'll put it over here so you don't get to walk right to the front. Let me know, we just kind of need to know, okay? This will probably be in a couple weeks, but let us know, please. There.
Yeah. about you. Dead wrong to ever doubt you. But my demons lay in wait and tempting me away. Oh, how I adore you. Oh, how I thirst for you. Oh, how I need you. Call the cards. I'll never wake up without an overdose of you. I don't wanna live, I don't wanna breathe. Let's feel you next to me. You take the pain out of me. Waking up for you, no, no, so real. I don't wanna sleep, I don't wanna dream.
Hey guys, welcome to Wave. Welcome to Wave. Welcome to Wave, guys. Okay, so welcome to Wave, guys. How y'all doing tonight? Okay, see, I did better, now you gotta do better, okay? Welcome to Wave, how you guys doing tonight? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. So glad you guys are here. Glad you guys watching online are here. I know Kara's online watching right now, so glad you're here. Yeah, it'll be a great night. Already having a great night. Already lots of exciting things going on. We got a fishing trip coming up that's super exciting. I cannot fish, but I might come just to watch you guys fish and try to catch seaweed. There we go. Late out, fishing edition for Late Night with Brian. That'd be fun. I just hope I don't start floating out to sea and Late Night with Brian will be gone. But, you know, we got so many things tonight. It's gonna be an awesome night for you guys. Couple surprises. First surprise, I want to ask Pastor John if he would come up because he's going to help with this one. And then we'll get the second surprise in just a little bit. But Pastor Johnny, I believe you have a surprise for someone here this evening.
I do. Jada Corson, I need you to come up here, please. Jada Corson. For those of you who do not know Jada, this is Jada Corson. She turned 15 today. 15, that's right. Come on, give her some love, and she's 15. Daniel, you sound like you were dying, like a dying cat. Some dying cats out there. Great. So, if you've never been to Wave before and you've never heard this edition, we don't do this every time, but we were actually doing it. We actually did it during our when we were strictly online. So we're kind of doing both. Kara, it's good. I'm so glad you, Kara, you're with us. So, what we do sometimes, what I try to do is attempt to do a brand new song that you've never heard before. It's totally improv. Like, I've never rehearsed this before. And so I decided that since it's Jada's birthday, that we're going to do an improv happy birthday song. And so my genre is rap. So I'm going to attempt to rap for Jada, a birthday rap. It'll be clean, don't worry, no explicit lyrics here and destination. Okay, I'm not sure what's going to come out as far as the lyrics, but I've got a beat that I want to let it roll. And then once we let that beat roll, listen to the quiet. This is, and some of you who are rap artists out there or who are rappers or you love rap music, don't judge me for the beat you're about to hear. It's a 90s beat, okay? I'm from the 90s. Some of you don't even know what that means. Actually, you know what that means, but you were born in 2000 plus. So I'm from the old, that's so crazy to think that 90s are old. I'm an old man. Okay. So let's go ahead and kick that. If y'all like, okay, here we go. Okay. Oh, listen to the beat. Okay, we gotta feel this. If y'all wanna feel it with me, you can. If y'all wanna get your phones out and videotape this, you can. I'm not sure. Okay, Jada, this one's for you. Jada Corson, that's your name. Looking right there like she's famous. And look at that smile, look at that grin. It makes me think that she's really kind of thin. Well, she is. She's really kind of cute. Is that... did I just hear you poot? Oh no, that wasn't a poop. That was just the way she talks, just the way she walks, and just the way she talks. But if you know Jada, she's a really cool kind of gal. Really, really cool kind of gal. Her name's not Sal, and she likes to go tripping, not the way that you think. Not the way that you think. Her tripping is taking care of little boys and girls. She's a babysitter, and that's how she does it. That's how her whirls. It's really, really cool. She's not a fool. She likes to swim in a pool. Huh. That's right, everybody. She's the coolest girl that I... well, not the coolest girl that I know. But one thing about Jada, she's not slow. She's fast. She's got a sharp mind. She likes to give everything she does. She's really kind, and she likes to find meaning in the things that she does. She does things without doubt because she loves Jesus Christ. She loves the Lord. She takes her sword and she beats it over the Satan's head and says, "Satan, oh, you better get back, boy. Cause if you don't, I'll take you out." Chipped up. Oh yeah, here we go with the flow. Kinda breaking it down for you, you know that you know. And so this is her birthday rhyme, it's her birthday rap. Everybody come on, put your hands together, let's clap and yeah, it's a birthday jam. If you're thinking about dating this girl, you better step back, cause she's got a dad and he'll take you out. For sure. And she's got a guy named Uncle Joe, that's me, you better watch out, I'll take you out too, boys. If you're looking at this girl and saying, "Wow, she's kind of fine, that's pretty cool, but you better whine and you better get your behind out of my face, you better get back, because she's really..." I'm not going to say what I really just thought, because if I said that, it would be not good in church, and so I'm not going to say it. So, everybody, if you could, sit your butt down here, please, if you would. The song's not done. We're gonna have fun, but I need everybody to understand that she is 15. She's the queen. She's got some dreams. She got some dreams. She's a really good cookie baker. She's not a faker, and she's kind of like a shaker. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it now. No, don't shake it. Better not do that. That would be bad in church, so don't do it. So, everybody on the count of three, we're gonna say happy birthday, Jada. Happy birthday, Jada. One, two, three. Yeah. All right. Hey, we got someone else. Stay right there for a second. Turn this way just a moment. Destiny, come on up here. There's one more thing as the groove keeps going. Y'all feeling it? Come on now. And she got her learners. So make sure you clear the roads if you see her driving. Okay? Okay. Now Destiny is about to rap for you. No, she's not. So we cut the music, Kale. That's his name, Kale. He likes a cool ale. Never mind, not ale. Ale, never mind. Here we go.
Stop. Okay. So my name is Destiny Mitchum, and I am Jada's best friend. I wanted to make this the specialest birthday ever, because I'm really proud to be your best friend for 15 years. I wanted to tell you, I made this gift especially for you to show you how much you really mean to me and a whole bunch of other people too. I asked so many people around this room what they think of you, and they all said all these.
Everybody go.
So I would like to thank Jada. Another happy birthday, hurrah.
Yes.
Okay, hold on. Turn it around. Let's read this. So this is Jada. She's funny, compassionate. I should have used this for my rap. Funny, compassionate, talented, selfless, outgoing, heartfelt, supportive, kind-hearted, spirited, perky, artistic, affectionate, sweet, hilarious, fantabulous. That's her word, by the way. Trustworthy, joyful, kind, caring, amazing. That's Jada. So y'all get up for Jada. Special day. Okay. You can have a seat, my dear. So we're going to roll something called... Brian, have you seen this yet? Where's Brian? I'll give it to you. Oh, dear. I'm kind of scared.
So, Sega Surprise is something I've been waiting for about 3 months now. Because, Kale likes to pick on me. He likes to make fun of me sometimes, puts my face on weird pictures and stuff. And, that's cool and all, but I've been promising revenge is coming. And he found out this week revenge came. And, So, Kale, let's show them what happened this week.
So you're telling me that Kale is deathly afraid of makeup?
Yeah.
Makeup of all things?
I know, right? I'm like, makeup?
What? Okay, well, look. Brian, tell Kale that next week, I'm doing the current.
Ooh.
Yeah. He gonna learn.
Oh, yeah.
He is gonna learn.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Brian, do you know where my phone is?
Okay, bye.
Why did you have that?
All right, listen.
Why were you talking to Brian?
Well, I was...
Hey, why were you talking to Brian?
All right, fine. You're so pathetic. I'm told Brian your situation.
You said what?
Well, he's going to be doing the video, current video for you next week.
No.
But can I show you some things?
Yes, please.
I knew things.
Attention.
So guys, I'm here next week.
Hey, the dinosaur.
You gonna learn.
So today, guys, I have two currents for you. I just want to let you know that we do, if you haven't been here for the past few weeks, we do have our small groups. And so if you will, make sure to sign up for those. And also, guys, I do want to just remind you to keep social distancing. I know it can be hard, but guys, social distancing can be a good thing. Yeah, you probably don't need to be shaking hands with that guy anyway, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, guys, so... No. Not today. No! No!
Current number three. You gonna learn.
Ryan? Ryan? This ain't fun anymore, Brian. Brian? Brian?
Well, okay. That was amazing. Kale, revenge. See, now Kale's going to go back and get him next week. It's just going to be a bad thing. Bad words going on. So, hey, one of the things we want you to do real quickly, this will take about 5 minutes, is this. Can everybody stand up? Okay, everybody stand up. If you would, please. So, one of the things that we are trying to do the best that we can, because as you guys know, we're not going to adrenaline, as you guys know that. Everybody go boo. I'm going boo, too. Not poo, boo, okay? Boo. So one of the things that we're trying to do is to create some activities and some things for us to do to do in maybe smaller groups. So here's what I need you to do. I need all of our small group leaders. So I need, Chris, come over here. Where's Chris Thigpen? Chris, come over here. If you're a middle school boy, go over and see Chris real quick. Here, Chris, take one of these things. You can write on it. All right. If you're a middle school boy, come over here with Chris right now. You guys got about 5 minutes. He's just going to ask, here's what we want you guys to do. Give us some ideas. What's some things that you could do that you want to see happen that maybe it won't probably be an all overnighter thing, but like two to six hours together. What's some activities you want to see happen? So we got middle school right here, right? Okay. If you are, okay, that's middle school. If you're going into ninth grade, ninth grade or above, boys with men with Jay. Jay's going to be right back there in the corner where Annie's at. Sorry, Annie. Right back there. So all you men that are going into ninth, all the way ninth through 12th, back there with Jay, you guys are going to give some ideas, all right? If you're going into middle school or you're going to be going into 6th through 8th grade, come up here. Come up here, KB, come up here. So if you're going in, if you're in middle school next year, okay, you're here, all right? Everybody good? So going in middle school, if you're 6th, 7th, or 8th grade, right here. High school is going to be in the back, right back here with Wendy and Annie and Emily. Y'all come back there. You guys got about 5 minutes, okay, not long, but we want you to go ahead and write, give us some ideas. We need your ideas. What are some fun things that you want to do? We've got some really cool things we think, but as we know, I'm 40 years old, and probably what I think is cool is not cool. So, you guys get about 5 minutes. We'll put a countdown on there. What are some ideas of things that you can do? So start, go ahead now. And remember, don't hold back. Like, you could be like, let's go swimming in the pool. Let's go fishing. Let's go grab some ice cream. Let's go out to eat. Let's go to Johnny and Winnie's house and toilet paper their yard. Not. Okay. Justin and Chelsea's yard. All right, guys, if you could make your way back to your seats, that would be great. This battery's about to die, just so you guys know. I feel like doing that. Some of you do not know this song. It goes, check, baby, 1, 2, 3, 4, check, baby. How many of y'all know that song? Anybody? It's called The Rump Shaker. Anyways, it's called The Rump Shaker. It's really cool. Actually, it's probably not a cool song. Never mind. Because the lyrics go to that song. All I want to do is do my zoom, 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 and a boom, boom. Yo, shake your rump. It's not a good song, so I won't sing it in church anymore. Just so you know, I need you to know all the words to that, but So those of you who are live with us, I apologize for that. Kara, are you still with us? I forgot about that. Hey guys, I wanted to let you know a couple things as we're moving into this kind of part of the service. Two things. First of all, next week, we're going to do things a little bit different. We're going to break into small groups tonight. Next week, we're not going to break into small groups. And we're going to have a time... I want to share with you something really that's been on my heart since last Sunday night. But next week we're going to have a time of worship, an extended time of worship and of also prayer. Because here's what I know about many of you right now. You're experiencing it's been a really rough time. The group that Miss Annie leads, which you guys are going to be, it's going to be awesome tonight in groups. I'm just excited about you guys being able to get together and talk and grow together. But one of the questions I asked the group there was, how's your relationship with God going? And the question was, do you feel like it's dying? Do you feel like you're just surviving? Or do you feel like you're thriving? Because in all areas of life, we can look at that, right? We can look at, man, it's dying, man. It's not good right now. Whether your relationship with your mom or dad, you feel like, you know, you're just your dreams, your goals, whatever. You can look at it as either it's dying, surviving, or thriving. And Jesus says this in his word, that I have come to give you life and give it to you to the full. In other words, I believe that Jesus wants you to thrive. And the reality is for so many of you, you're just in a crazy moment right now, where you're just surviving, or maybe you feel like you're just dying. And that grieves me, and it grieves our leaders. And it's not a judgmental statement at all. Please hear me. It's just a heart. It's just a reality of where some of you are right now. And I can tell you this. It's a reality of where some of us leaders have been too. Leaders, can I see your hands if we've been there a little bit too? Leaders, so if you look around, you're your adult leaders. We've been in kind of like that mode as well. Like feeling like we're just surviving this thing. And I know that in the moments when I feel like I'm surviving or I feel like I'm dying, there's some things that really help me. Number one is to gain perspective on who I am. I'm a child of God, and Jesus loves me no matter who I am or what I've done, and he's always with me. Yesterday morning was the darkest time I think I've had in my life ever. I've been experiencing some weird issues with my jaw and my ear. It's weird. I'm going to have some answers hopefully tomorrow. But yesterday, I felt this deep, dark cloud. I don't know if you guys have ever felt it. I think I've known you guys. And it felt like it was looming over me, pushing me down. Like, I didn't even want to do anything. I want to get back in. And if those of you who know me, I'm not that guy. But I felt like in that moment, I was that guy. And I'm like, this is not me. What's going on? And I know some of you feel that way oftentimes. God, what's going on? Is this the way it's going to be? And is this, why is this happening? I wish I could tell you why it's happening. I wish I could tell you this is the answer. All you got to do is just pray and God's going to take care of you. It's going to go all the way. God's going to be with you.
But sometimes God's with us through the storm. We ask God to take the storm away, but God wants to dance with you through the storm in a very close, intimate dance. And it's hard. So one of the things I try to do is acknowledge that. The other thing I do is I ask people to pray for me that I trust. Say, listen, guys, I'm in a funk. I call it a funk, whatever you call it. I don't know whatever you call it, but all of us have been there. Deep hole, depression, anxiety. Kara, I know we've talked about it. A lot of you have been through that. All of us probably have been through issues, right? We all have been through there. Whether you're online with us or you're here, you've been through funks. You've been through issues. In fact, some of you are there right now. And I wish I could just say, in Jesus' name, be gone. And it's totally gone from you. And that doesn't take away the power in the mighty name of Jesus. Because there's so much power in that. So what I've learned is to ask people to pray for me. So next week, we're going to do that. We're going to really take some time. It's going to be rearranged in here a little differently. We're going to have some chairs. We're going to invite some of our prayer team that in our church to come and to pray over you. If you want, you know, like personal prayer, and we're going to speak words of life over you. Words that's going to remind you of who you are. Remind you that God's not done with you. Remind you that though we're in this crazy COVID craziness and our world seems to be just so dysfunctional and out of whack, that we can stand on the truth that God is good. The second thing I do is I worship. I used to not. I used to be that guy that I'm not going to worship because I don't feel it. If I don't feel it, then I'm not going to worship. I was that guy. And some of you are like, I feel like if I start worshiping and I start praising God, I'm not being real. But what I realize is that you worship through it. I'm speaking these words over my life, even though I don't feel it. And young people, I know that some of you don't feel it right now. And I'm sorry, I wish I could make you feel it, but it's not always about feelings. It's about truth. The truth that Jesus loves you, the truth that he's got a plan for you, the truth that he's with you no matter what. So I just begin to worship sometimes. I crank it up, I sing loud, I sing off key, I rap, I bebop sometimes. That's my prayer language. Actually, I don't know, some people say that's like, I don't know what you're doing, but it's weird. I don't care. But it began to remind myself of who I am. I praise through it. So in these moments, young people, as we just take time, I don't know where you are on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being, man, this has been the worst year of your life. Maybe that's where you are. That's where I am. And that's maybe reality. And I don't take away the reality of how you feel, but I do want to remind you of who you are. You belong to the King of Kings. You're a princess. You're a prince bought with a price. And he has plans that are good. And he wants to use you to continue to change the world. That dream you had back when 2020 started, it's not done with. And sometimes we got to remind ourselves of who God is. So in these moments, you know, I just want to invite you to worship through it. I really want to invite you not to chit-chat with each other, but to take a moment and to focus. Maybe for some of you, you need to, as we stand, if you stand, to spread out a little bit more and just get in that space. I've got to get in that space where I don't think of anything else. Breathe you in, Jesus. Because he knows how you feel. Some of you just need that hug. And I hate it that I can't hug you. But I know this. Your Heavenly Father loves you. And in a moment, in worship, I felt the most amazing embraces by a Father that loves me. Not for what I've done, but simply because I'm his child. So God, in these next few moments as we just begin to worship, I just ask that you begin to break some things down. I know tomorrow we would have been on the road to adrenaline, and we're not. And it sucks. But God, you can break through regardless of that. Holy Spirit, you can break down walls tonight. So I'm just going to have enough faith, which is not much, to believe that you want to do something tonight, Holy Spirit, in the lives of a young lady, in the lives of a young man, in the lives of a leader. And maybe just do it as we sing to you, as we sing through. So we just give you this time in Jesus' name. Amen. So if y'all want to stand, you can stand. If you want to sit, you can sit. But let's just worship. I am healed in your hands. lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Just declare that all my life. In all my life you have been faithful, in all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. My life down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Do you believe that, young people? Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. My life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life you have been, all my life. Remember the faithful moments. I know it's hard sometimes. And all my life you have been so, so good. He's never left you. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness.
Darkness fails, it will prevail. Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. My God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord.
You know, I just keep thinking, please. You know, I just feel like some of you, you're battling something. And I know that sometimes it just takes a bold move. Like, we have a thing. We call it an altar. It's where God can alter things in your mind and your life. And so it's like, it can be right through your chair. But for some of you, I think you need some boldness to say, God, the victory belongs in you. And I'm struggling and I'm battling right now. But I want to come right here and lay it down and say, God, this is yours. I'm struggling. I'm giving it to you. And so we want to give you permission. I know that you're in this moment. But to give you permission to come to the altar and say, God, I'm laying it down right here. The altar is open anytime tonight while we're praying. So please know that this is your moment to be able to break through with that.
There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. Every war he wages, he will win. I'm not backing down from any giant, for I know that story ends. For I know how this story ends. I'm gonna see a victory.
And declare it.
I'm gonna see a victory. The battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord.
I'm gonna see.
Yes, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the
I need to share something, but I don't ever come on stage, so forgive my shakiness. But in Galatians 4:5, it says to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship. And I feel like some people feel like you're not in the family anymore. And the thing with adoption is, in Hebrew culture, if you're adopted, you can't be disowned.
if you were born to this family, you can be disowned. But if you're adopted, you cannot be disowned. And somebody in here is running, but God just wants you to know he's right behind you. All you have to do is turn around and he's got open arms. And he's right there with you. So if that's you, just turn around. He's right there. He loves you so much. You are not disowned. He is not a bad father. He's running after you with open arms. So that's it.
Light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Sing again, Waymaker, declaring this.
Waymaker.
You need a miracle in your life. That's who he is.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. Worship.
Mending every heart.
You are here, mending every heart. Worship.
You are the Waymaker.
Waymaker, spiritual promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God.
Waymaker.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You are.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who.
You're my waymaker, Jesus.
You're my waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
Come on, sing it, sing it.
You're my waymaker, you're my waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. That is who you are. You're my waymaker.
promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Cause that is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Name of Jesus. God, we just thank you so much for this time. Lord, you just inhabit our praises. That means you come and you live here. As we lift up your voice, as we lift up your name with our voices, as we pour out our hearts to you, you come and you live here. You don't just visit. You come and you stay. It's in these moments, Father, when we realize and recognize that your presence is always and forever with us. There is nothing that can separate us from your love. Not famine, not persecution, not hatred, not COVID-19, not racial discrimination, not fear, not anger. There is nothing that can separate us from your love. You have such passion for us, Father. Such desire for us. So right here, right now, Lord, at your feet, we just humble ourselves in your presence. Thank you. Lord, just let my tears right now, Lord, let my tears just pour on your feet like Mary's. Lord, how I long to just be in your presence. We fight the depression. We fight the hurt. We fight the fear. We just cast it out in the midst of our praise. You no longer can be in here. Our shackles are freed as we fight our battles with praise. Chains are loosened. The ropes that once held us down and tied us, they're no longer there. They've fallen off in the midst of praise in His presence. Yes, Jesus. Given us this opportunity to worship You, just to be in Your presence. And so, Lord, as we go through the rest of this evening, as we now prepare our hearts to begin to open up to Your Word, to open up to Your Spirit teaching us, leading us, Father God, we just ask that You would just minister to us continuously, continuing to show us just how passionate and how loving God You are. And we thank You for all of this and pray it in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right.
We're fixing to break into our groups. Can we have that list again, Christine? Where's Miss Christine? Can you bring that list up here to Pastor Jay? I'm going to have him scroll through that real quick with everybody, because I know some of you, this is your first time with us, and just to get into those groups. Some of you know where you're going, so we don't have to redo that. But so next week, I encouraged our worship leaders that are going to be their team of amazing young men and women, man right now, and women, Ryan, man. I just encourage them to just, when you come next week, don't hesitate. Bring it all. Bring all everything. When I say bring it all, when I say bring all your worship, just bring it all so you can lay it all down. I can't fix, I can't save, but I know the one that can.
That's right.
And we want to intercede and pray on your behalf. So I'm so sorry I'm emotional. I'm not sorry I'm emotional. We weep with you and we weep for you. But I'm excited about group time, and it's just so cool to see some really cool, all you guys are cool, but really cool people I haven't seen in a while. And soon I'm going to give you a hug, and it's going to like crush you because I haven't been able to give you guys hugs. Whenever they give me the green flag to hug, it's better be on. I'm going to say like I'm hugging you. So anyways, Pastor Jay.
All right, guys. All right, here we go. All right. For those in Justin and Chelsea's group, it's Daniel Mitchum, Carson Brennick, Rhythm Broadhead. Okay, y'all are going to DC 1 or 2 or somewhere. So if y'all would come out to this door down here, all right, y'all can head on when Miss Chelsea gets over there with you. Will we love you? All right. While she's going to get those out of there, we're going to go with Miss Christine's Get Out of Your Head. That's going to be Jazzy Corson, Lillian Bailey, Elijah Bailey, Lauren Fay, Isabella Fazio, Hannah Perkins, Mackenzie Thigpen, Lacey Morris, Emma Barber, and Abigail Head. If y'all would meet Miss Christine right out there, and she will take y'all around a journey so that you can start your awesome study together. Then Miss Annie's group which will meet over here at this door to go to my town. That is Curtis, Jada, Destiny, Allie, Hannah, Lexi, Jesse, Gracie, and Jamie. Wow. That just ended with a bunch of E's. All right. Awesome. All right. So that should leave Alyssa, Jade, Jacob, Brennan, Walker, Zachary, Kale, Will, Eli, Luke, Ryan, Amaya, and Alicia. Right? All right. So, y'all scoot down this way. Now, I do have to keep the mic, as I told the guys last week. Our group actually is doing the online. So whoever's online is actually going to be watching us as well. So they're going to get to see everything that we're seeing and doing everything that we're doing along with us. All right. So that's one. Two is I encouraged everybody last week to take out your phones. So if you don't have a phone, then you probably want to try to bring like a notebook or something like that that you can take notes on. All right. But in your phones, I want you to open up your notes. Okay, you should have started, those of you who were here last week probably should have started some notes with us last week. If you have not, then go ahead and start your notes with us tonight. There's going to be times throughout the night where I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to ask you a question, and I'm going to give you a couple minutes to just answer those questions in your notes, okay, because they're pertinent questions for you to reflect back on. Not just during our time together, but during the week. Then also, you know, maybe later on down as you learn more and more about your relationship with God and you grow in your relationship with God, then there's going to be times where you will pull those notes back up. You'll see them in your phone. You'll pull them back up and you'll read them and you'll think, wow. Okay? And it's going to be powerful for you, I promise. All right? Back in the olden days, back when, you know, there were stage coaches and things like that, and I was a boy, we used to do things called writing, where we would take like a pencil or a pen, and we would put things down on paper. And I actually found one of my old notebooks a few months back, and I started reading in there, and I was like, man, this is incredible. I didn't realize I was such an idiot. All right, so tonight we're going to jump in deep, all right? Last week we were kind of on the edge of deep, but tonight we're jumping in deep. Y'all like swim? Those of you who go to swimming pools, and you go to swim pools, how many of you just kind of wade in slowly and just kind of got to get used to the water? That's the way Miss Christine is. She's just like, I gotta get used to the water. You know, she's really slow, and about 30 minutes later, she might be up to her chin, but it's going to take her about that long. Where the rest of us, I hope, and it's much easier this way, I encourage you to do this. Dive right in. Get that chill off, get used to it, and get to swimming. That's what it's all about, right? Well, tonight, we're going to dive right in. We're going to jump into the deep end of the pool tonight, okay? So get your notes out. If you want to take some notes during the video, do so. We're going to watch the video real quick, and then we're going to jump into it, all right?
We live on an amazing planet. I mean, it's insane when you think about just our existence and the way that we think and the way that we live. And when you look at creation and you see these trees and it's just all of God's creation, it's hard to imagine, right, that all of this was an accident. Like, it was just a coincidence that there was nothing or little particles that suddenly formed all of this. But the moment your mind starts to go, you know what, there has to be a creator, the moment you start to go there, you go, then, but if he's so good and so powerful, why is there so much pain and suffering in this world? I mean, why right now am I standing at my mother's grave? If God is so good, why did she die while she was giving birth to me? That doesn't make sense. I mean, if he's all powerful, he could have stopped that. Why did the God who created laughter create tears? The God who created life create death? And why if he's so good, after my dad remarried, why is it that when I finally had a mom again, that my stepmom dies in a car accident? I was only 8 years old. And then why, if we've got this holy, wonderful God, if he's so wonderful, why did my dad die of cancer when I was 12 years old? Explain that. I mean, I'm in middle school. I don't have parents anymore. And some of you have gone through things even more painful than that. And if God is so good, these are the thoughts that run through our mind because something doesn't seem right. We see all the beauty, we see all the majesty, but then we see the pain and go, man, this doesn't seem right. And that's exactly what the Bible teaches too. It says, look, this isn't the way it was meant to be. Something did go wrong. See, in Genesis 1, after God created the world and created Adam and Eve, he told them, look, everything here on this earth, it's for you. Okay, you rule over it. You take care of it. You enjoy it. He goes, but there's one tree, and I don't want you to eat of that one tree. He goes, in fact, if you eat of that tree, everything's going to change. The moment God gave them that command, he was also giving them a choice. A choice between good and evil, a choice to obey or a choice to rebel. Had they obeyed, everything was going to be good. But because they rebelled, God warned them. He says, look, if you eat of that tree, you will die. Death will enter the world. And so when they were tempted and they ate of that, God had to come true with what he promised. He says, look, I told you, this was the warning. And right then, everything changed. And suddenly death entered the world and there was a curse upon this earth. So when you and I look at things on this earth and go, something seems wrong, something seems off, we're absolutely right. This wasn't what he wanted. It wasn't what he intended. But what the Bible says is that one day, things are going to change and he's going to redeem the world and there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth and everything's going to be different. But until then, we're here and we face pain. But the crazy thing about it is the Bible says that God can even use the pain that we're suffering right now for his glory. He can turn it into a good thing. That's why in James chapter 1, verse 2, he says, consider it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness, and let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. He says, look, even if you're going through difficult times, you can find joy in that. In fact, you can count it all joy because he says what God does is not just redeem the whole world, but he even redeems this pain in our lives. He says he can actually use it to make us stronger. It's the very thing that brings steadfastness or perseverance into us. And he says if you let it have its perfect result, then you yourself become mature and complete. That's why some of the elderly people that you know that have so much character and just seem so far beyond us, man, look into their lives. It's because they went through some pain and they made it through. And God says, that's why I use pain. I can actually use it for your benefit to make you a strong person, mature, complete, lacking in nothing. Because it's during those difficult times that we would actually draw close to him. Think of it like this. It's like when you're making a cake, you know, you use ingredients like flour and butter and eggs and sugar. And if you look at each ingredient, like the butter, you ever take like a half a cube of butter and throw it in your mouth and suck on it? I mean, it's gross. Or you take a handful of flour and throw it in your mouth. terrible. Or you crack an egg, it's horrible. And you know the sugar's fine, but you mix it all up and you throw it in an oven and out comes this mature, complete. You're concerned about the end result. And that's what God's saying, is there are ingredients He throws in our lives. But what we don't understand is, man, those things mixed in, He's concerned about who we are at the end of our lives. He says, you can use this process to redeem you. It will make you mature and complete. In fact, the Bible says later on in verse 12, it says, blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial, for when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love Him. He says, the person who makes it through and doesn't just freak out and curse God and just ditch Him, the person who actually perseveres through the trial, because there's something that trial does in us to strengthen us. It's easy to love God when He just gives you everything you want. But what if you go through some difficult times? Do you actually cling to Him for that? Do you cling to Him during those times? Do you draw near in faith to Him? Because He says the person who receives the crown of life is the person who loves Him. And the person who loves Him is the one who endures the trial. You see, trials can actually be a good thing. I can look back at my life now and say, God, I'm actually grateful that my parents died at a young age, because it caused me to think differently about life. From the time I was in middle school on, I started to ask myself questions like, what is this all about? I don't take any day for granted. I don't take for granted that I have tomorrow, that by the time you're watching this, that I'm still gonna be on the earth. I don't know that. And so I make the most of every day. When I put my kids to bed at night, man, I don't just assume, oh, I'll see them tomorrow. All these are good things. It caused me to cherish life, but it also caused me to pursue God. I mean, when I'm 12 and I don't have parents, I'm thinking, okay, what's this life all about? This can end at any second. Like, this could be my last day on earth. I better figure out what's after that. Man, and it was during that time that I began to question, what is this all about? Is there something bigger than me? Is He for real? Can I know Him? What's it gonna be like when this life is all over? See, it was the deaths of my parents that caused me to think of these things and caused me to eventually find God and know Him like I do. And anything that would cause me to find God is a huge blessing, no matter how painful it was at the time. I've met many people who've come to God, come to know Him through the most painful times of their lives, because they saw, okay, this can't be coincidence, but I don't understand this pain. But it's as they tried to figure it out, they found God.
Okay, so the first thing I want you to do in your notes is I want you to answer this question to the best of your ability, okay? Why do bad things happen? That's it. Nothing else. Just why do bad things happen? You know, hearing Francis Chan's story is somewhat overwhelming, you think about it. Living a life where you feel like you may be to blame for the death of your mother because she dies at childbirth. Then, you know, to finally get a mother and that mother dies and then the father dies. You just think about how the loss that he
felt and experienced at an early age. And some of you may have felt that kind of loss yourselves, maybe facing that kind of loss even now, dealing with it. And I think that that's exactly what this question begs. Why do bad things happen? What is it that causes these horrible things to happen? Well, hopefully we all know, and if we don't know, then we're going to share it with you. It all comes down to the fact that we failed God. Now, we sometimes want to blame that on Adam and Eve, but the truth of the matter is that had we been there in the garden, had it been us, honestly, I'd have taken the apple. Sooner or later, the temptation would have gotten too much for me. I know I would have, because I'm not that strong. I have temptations that I face every day. Sometimes I win, sometimes I lose. And I bet you do too, don't you? So let's take a look at it. Genesis 2, 16 through 17. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat from it, you will certainly die." Now the serpent was more crafty than any of the wild animals the Lord had made. He said to the woman, "Did God really say you must not eat from any tree in the garden?" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat fruit from the trees in the garden, but God did say you must not eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden, and you must not touch it, or you will die." You will not certainly die," the serpent said to the woman. "For God knows that when you eat from it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." And when the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food, and pleasing to the eye, and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it. She also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate it. Then the eyes of both of them were opened, and they realized they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves. Humanity was created for the purpose of being in a loving relationship with God. But loving relationships, while because we are flawed, they err, they shouldn't err. Something went wrong. Have y'all ever been in a relationship where something went wrong? Any of you? We all have. Maybe a girlfriend, a boyfriend, maybe just a friend, where something happened. Starts out as just joking around, and the next thing you know, you're throwing blows at each other. That happened to me when I was 7. I had a, we were out just kicking the ball around, playing. We were fixing to start a game of kickball. And this one little boy, he was a little bit younger than me, was out there with us, and he did something or said something, I don't remember, and I kind of snapped back at him just in jest, just playing around. Well, one of my friends didn't like the way I said it, and he jarred back at me, and I jarred back at him. And the next thing I know, we're rolling around on the dirt, beating the tar out of each other. Something went wrong. It really didn't even have anything to do with us. Things happen, right? So
So when Adam and Eve fell, a curse came upon the earth. What's a curse? Somebody tell us, what's a curse?
Speak loudly.
What did you say, Eli? A spell. What do you mean by a spell? Okay, something that can't be undone. All right? Somebody else, what's a curse? Oh, you got your phones right there in your hands. Man, if I was like, if I'd had that when I was y'all's age, I'd been like the smartest kid in the room because I'd be like, yeah. What is it, Ryan? You didn't look it up? Oh, you're texting somebody. I got you. Calling them out. All right. Who's got it? What's a curse? Really? I give you permission to use your phones and y'all is just like sitting there. I don't get it. Okay. Okay, so a supernatural power to inflict harm or what? Punishment. Punishment, okay. So in other words, there are consequences for actions, right? Y'all know that? Y'all ever had to deal with consequences? Anybody other than me have to deal with consequences? Yeah, we all have to deal with consequences from time to time. Some consequences we are okay with, some we really don't like, right? Right? So we've got to be watchful and mindful of the fact that we have to deal with the consequences of the curse that's on the world. But God has said that one day he will make everything new and there will be a new heaven and a new earth. Ultimately, God has promised us that there's going to be a day when he's going to set everything right. All the bad, what's gone wrong, he's going to fix. James 1, 2 through 4 says this. It says, count all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. Let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. So here's my question for you. Are you ready? What is steadfastness? What is steadfastness? What does it mean to be steadfast? Somebody got it? You got it. I know you do.
Yeah. The quality of being dutifully firm and unwavering.
Okay. So being dutifully firm and unwavering is what I heard. Like, so in other words, you're sticking the course, you're staying with it, even when it seems like everything's against you. Okay? You're sticking to it. Now here's the question I have about this statement from James, though, not just the steadfastness. I want you to understand the steadfastness. But in your notes, I want you to answer this question. How can one count all their pain and trials as joy? Because that's what he says right there, right? He says, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. How can we count all the trials that we face joy? Answer that in your notes. How do you make joy out of struggles?
So there's a lot of times in life when we face things that we don't like. We have to deal with the consequences of our actions. Sometimes we have to deal with the consequences of somebody else's actions, right? But the cool thing is that God can use all of our situations. Notice I didn't say that God causes all of our situations, but God can use all of our situations to help us in the end, to become a better person. There have been times in my life when I've gone through some really bad, hard things. For instance, those of you who do not know me, I used to be a pastor, a full-time pastor in a church, and I was the end-all, be-all. I was it, I'm telling you. I was the best pastor those little 30 people in that little church ever had. I was young, I was vibrant, and I was arrogant. Anybody know what arrogant means? Okay. That means that I was full of myself, right? What ended up happening was because of my arrogance and because of my thinking that I was all that and whatever, that I ended up losing my ministry. I ended up losing it. I ended up walking away from full-time ministry. Now, I still believe today that God has called me to full-time ministry. But the cool thing about it is this. You see, when I went through all of that struggle of fighting in ministry, it brought me here. And being here at Destination has turned my life completely around. Because I'm no longer that arrogant, thinking I'm the best of all things. He's made me humble in the midst of it. And I can truly say that because of the struggles that I faced, I actually am better off now than I would have been if everything worked out the way that I wanted it to. So Francis Chan uses this analogy of the cake. What'd y'all think of that analogy of cake? That's pretty good, right? I mean, especially when you start thinking about actually putting butter in your mouth, right? Anybody do that? Anybody ever eaten just straight butter? All right, so I'm going to tell you a secret. Don't tell Andy that I said this, but she used to eat whole sticks of butter. She loved butter when she was a kid, okay? So, yeah, butter's not that bad. Have y'all ever eaten flour? Anybody ever eaten flour? Yeah. So I make homemade biscuits, okay? So the cool thing about homemade biscuits is when you get through making all the biscuits, sometimes you'll have a little bit of dough left over, and homemade biscuit dough really is good. Raw. It is. But if you ever just get a clump of flour, ew, right? How about, it's already 8 o'clock. Goodness gracious. I don't have my clock up there, so I don't see what time it is. All right, so all of those different ingredients, right? But if you put them all together, shake them up, stir them up, throw them in the oven, out comes a awesome cake, right? Do y'all like cake? Anybody like cake? Ice cream cake? All right. So, but the fact of the matter is that it's good at the end, right? All those things by themselves, they might be painful, they might be gross, they might make you want to vomit. If you ate a raw egg, I couldn't do it. I've seen people do it. It's gross. I couldn't do it. But hey, you know what? When you put it all together, you get something really good, right? And so that's the key to all of this, is to make sure that you know that in the end, God's going to work all things out for his good, and he's going to make it work out. So regardless of what you're going through, regardless of what you're facing, I'm not telling you right now that what you're facing is is easy. I'm not telling you what you're facing is to be ignored. It's real. But I want you to have this hope. Because the important thing is that hope does not disappoint. Okay? We cannot lose hope. Hope is what we cling to. And as long as you have hope, then you've got everything that you need. And the hope is that in the end, God's going to work out all things for the good of those who love Him, who are called by His name. All right? So let's pray and we can get out of here. Father, we thank You for the night. We thank You for the opportunity that we've had to just, oh, Lord, what an awesome time of worship we had tonight, Lord. It's just been so great. Father, I thank You for those guys who are in here tonight that haven't been with us in a while. Father, I pray blessing on each one of these guys here tonight, Lord. I pray that You would just continue to just nourish them in Your word, Father. Lord, I pray that You would give them opportunity to just grow in their relationship with You and their love for You, Father. And Lord, I pray that they have a great week the rest of this week. And until I see their faces, I pray that they would count everything joy. They would be filled with joy. And that they would go out and just proclaiming and living a life of the relationship that they have with You, Father. I thank You for all of this in Your name. Amen and amen. All right. So you guys can go on out the doors back there and head on. Hey, it was great seeing you. We hope that y'all had a great time tonight. And look forward to seeing you later.
Minio, say it with me, Minio. Okay, great, two forks high, raise the stakes. Risk it all, I take the hate. It's the winning team, get the Gatorade. My guy good, but he's not safe, nah.
They try to shut us down and it ain't gonna slide. Only thing I fear is God and He on my side. That's the confidence of God, cause He got me. That's why I really feel like
you can't stop me. Like Kendrick, never be the rapper I got from Hendrix. Top 10 alive, you will never be mentioned. Why aim so high, won't survive the trenches. Plus, you a Christian, Andy. They will never listen, Andy. Plus, we a pigment, Andy. You don't got skill, you a gimmick, Andy. Well, if I listen to you and everything you put in my ear, I'll be living like woulda, shoulda, coulda. I'll be paralyzed by fear. Ain't that the truth? If I quit, the only way I lose. I got two choices when I do this. Make moves or make excuses, huh? If you know who I'm talking about, then you got me. My biggest enemy is me, and even I